Now we are supposed to solve a problem. So consider that a list containing the elements as 6, 23, 512, 7429, and then 6, 61, let's say, and then 7, 9, 8, 4, 3, and let's say here 1, right? So what you are supposed to do is that you are supposed to count that how many numbers are present in this list such that those numbers are containing even number of digits. So if you see, 23 contains even number of digits, right? So how many such numbers are there? 1, this 23, then 7429, this is second number, and then this 61 is the third number. So there are three such numbers which are containing even number of digits present in them, right? So the output in that case should be 3. Now if you observe this number 6, it contains only one digit, that is odd number of digits, right? Again 512, this contains 3 digits, which is again odd number of digits. So you are just supposed to count that how many numbers are there which are containing even number of digits. That should be clear, okay? So just pause the video and try to write the code for that. Alright, so let us move to the solution part now. So consider that the name of this list is, let's say, LT, list or array, whatever you like to say, and the number of elements that is present within this list is represented by n. So we are supposed to write an algorithm now. Now the algorithm is going to be very simple. So how can we write that? First of all, we already know that how can we write the algorithm for counting the number of digits. So count number of digits, right, in any number, let's say n. So let me write here n1. So let us say if n1 is a number, we already know that what should be the instructions that we should execute in order to count the number of digits that is present in a number. That we already know, right? So this we can write. The point is here, I will just pass each of the numbers that is present in my list one by one, and if that number, let's say, if you consider n1 value currently 6, so I already know I can just count the number of digits. So if you observe, the number of digits present in this number 6 is 1. 1 is odd number. So in that case, I won't count it, right? So I can take a counter, initialize this to 0. So 6, first of all, I will just take this 6. So is this 6, right? This number 6, is it containing even number of digits or odd number of digits? Of course, odd number of digits. So in that case, I will not increase my count, right? So I'll skip this part. Now 23. Containing even number of digits, yes. So in that case, I will increase the counter by 1. Then next number, 512. Right, I'll just reject this. Then 512. Is it containing even number of digits or odd number of digits? Of course, odd number of digits. So in that case, I won't increase this counter. Right. So the idea is very simple. That means that if the element that is present in list or array contains even number of digits, in that case, I will increase this counter by 1. So increment counter by 1. Otherwise, don't do anything. That's it. So that's the whole idea. So first of all, write a algorithm for counting the number of digits, and then check if the element that is present in the list is containing even number of digits. In that case, increase the counter by 1. Otherwise, no need to do anything else. And finally, after coming out of this, all the iterations of this, right, that means after traversing the entire array or list, just come out and print the value of counter, which will contain the count of even number of digits, right? So the numbers which are containing your even number of digits, right? So in that case, if you observe this list, it contains three such numbers, that is a 23, 7429, and then 61. So these are the only three numbers, so output should be 3 in that case. So now we can convert this idea into actual code now. So let me write down the boilerplate code first of all, that is hash include iostream, and then here int main, and here return 0. Okay, now I'll take int n, that represents the size of the array. So standard cout, enter the value of n. So enter n simply, and then using cin statement, I can read the value of n. So standard cin n. So once this is done, I can just consider my array, that is int star lt, assignment operation, and then new int n, that is the size of the array. And then I'm supposed to ask the user to enter the values one by one. So the message for the user, enter the values one by one. Okay, so once this is done, Now I'll just take a loop that is for int I starting from 0, I less than n, and here I should increment every time by 1. And here I can just read the values one by one. So standard cin. So at every index I'll read the values. So once this is done, now what we can do, we can declare the function. So here the return type should be int, because I'm supposed to count the number of digits, right? So count digits, and here int n, let's say. This is my function declaration, right? Now here what I can do, I can write my function, that is definition here, that is int count digits and here int n, right? And now I already know that how can we count the number of digits, so that's very easy. So I can just take a counter here, int ct assigned to 0, while number is greater than 0. In that case I can just write here, and I can just strip off the trailing digits one by one, and while stripping off I am supposed to increase the value of counter by 1 every time. So ct increments by 1 every time, and finally once you come out of this loop you are supposed to return the value of ct, that is the count of digit. So now my function or machine, whatever you like to say, is ready to count the number of digits. So now I can traverse the entire array. So for that I can write for int I starting from 0, I less than n, and the value of I should increment every time by 1, right? Now I can just check the condition, if count digits for the current element, that is list of I. So if this count of digit, if this is even, so in that case modulo 2, so I will divide the number by 2, number of digits by 2. If this is even, in that case I will print lt of I simply. So standard cout print, that is your lt of I, right? So actually I'm supposed to count the number of digits, but along with that let me print the values as well, right? And here let's say I'll separate these elements by slash t. So after printing I'll just increment the value of counter here. So let me take the counter, that is even counter, right? Even number of digits counter, ECTR, and this one I'll assign to 0. So just after printing I will increase the value by 1. So ECTR, I'll increment this one by 1. Okay, so you can even write ECTR plus plus, that is also fine, but I'll be writing it plus assign 1, just for more clarity, that's it. Now in the else part we need not do anything, right? So now I'll just print out this value of ECTR that represents the total number of, right, the elements that are containing your even number of digits, right? So I'll write here result, and here before printing the result let me put a new line here, slash n, and then along with that I'll print this variable ECTR, right, followed by new line. So once it is done, now let me compile this code, that is make test, so there are no errors. Now dot slash test, so enter n. So how many numbers, that is your 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so let me enter 7 numbers here, right? So 7, what are the elements? 6 23 512, 6 then 23 and then 512, after that 7 4 2 9 7 4 2 9, then 61, after that 7 9 8 4 3 7 9 8 4 3, and then here 1. So let me hit enter. So you can see the result is 3, and the three numbers are 23 7 4 2 9 61. So these are the three numbers containing even number of digits, right? So I hope it is clear. So let me run this program once more for different inputs. So let's say this time 8 values. So let me enter random numbers here, okay, anything that I like, and then here something, so 8 such random numbers, okay. So you can see again the result is 3, because so it is, you can say by chance, that there are 3 numbers that I have entered here which are containing even number of digits, right? So let me run it once more. You might think that only for 3 it is working, but it is not like that. Let me enter the numbers 25, then 36, then 9874, then 56561, and then here 21, then 236, and here 8945. So there are five such numbers which are containing even number of digits, and these are the numbers 25 36 9 8 7 4 21. So you can clearly see, so this program is working completely fine. So I hope it is clear.